I plead the blood of Holy Yahushua over this video and over the mind, body, and spirit of every child of Yah watching this video in Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name.
On November 7th, I was awakened to these words I heard before the massacre matrix vortex. And then the Lord had given me a vision. He brought me in the spirit and I was above the earth. And he was showing me that he was referring to a worldwide event. Then right after that, the Lord said that there would be a birthing before the complete destruction. And as he said this, he was showing me a vision of twins in a womb with symbols of royalty around it. What's interesting about this vision is that a child in a womb is commonly known to face down in the womb, but I was shown two that were not only facing up, but they were face to face also. Another point that I think is important to mention is that another messenger, Diana Olivieri. Months ago, I had seen a few videos of hers where she shares that the Lord had spoke about these twins being birthed, these twin sons, and he said that it was for a dual purpose. So what's being revealed to us here is before the complete destruction, with the heavens rolling up like a scroll, or a whirlwind, there will be a spiritual birthing of the Lord's royal priesthood. So this next message and vision I received on the 12th of November, the Lord had given me a vision of written scripture. The Bible was opened up in front of me, and he said, "We need to fly." Then I looked down at the pages that were opened in front of me, and three different times the Lord placed the words, "We need to fly," over the scripture that I was trying to read. Listen to what the Spirit is saying. Be ready, brothers and sisters, because it is the season. It's time to fly. Time to fly. All glory to the Most High God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Yahushua HaMashiach. He's revealing so many things, for the Lord promises us that He does not do anything before revealing it to His servants first. Thanks for listening, you guys. I love you all, and God bless you.
Shabbat Shalom, saints, and welcome back to Wakefulness Theology. My name is Messenger Paula. There is so much to tell you. It is only through the Holy Spirit that I can organize this information and vocalize this information with you. It's just beyond human ability. So thankfully, Ruach HaKodesh has given me this tool here to help me organize the information. As you know, we have almost come to the end of this first row. We've gone through the five trees here. We've talked about the seals. We've already gone through healing and faith, and we've already gone through the portal. Now there's more to talk about with the portal before we finish with this first row, but we've already started talking about the tesseract and the fifth dimension. Here in this row right here, we can see all of the Bible verses and all of the holy letters and other associated information that has supported what we've understood in this first row. We've talked about the first group that is involved, and I mean, we've said before that the five groups of the bridal army, they're one. It's like five fingers of the same hand. But this aspect of being a leader, a part of the five groups, we've discussed as far as judgment or double blessing. One thing we have not yet discussed are the five elements. Now, this is a new aspect of the message that we're receiving. Sister Polly and Sister Judy, and I think also Sister Brittany, some of us in Wakefulness Theology Group are being bombarded with the messages about the ether. Now, we're not going to talk about that today, but it's another big part of this message that we're going to have to understand. I've seen some brothers and sisters in Christ having dreams about Einstein. That's what this is involving. It's involving the fifth element. And now that's a movie that was with Bruce Willis that I've seen years ago. Maybe we should look at that movie again. I don't know. But that's what they were talking about in that movie, the fifth element, which is the ether, which is, you know, this air that we can't see, like, you know, space, air in front of us here. And that is exactly what they're trying to understand in those experiments that they're doing at CERN. That's what it is. So apparently this ether is a fifth element, and right now the Holy Spirit wants us to understand it. Gone ahead and added this chart here. You can see we've talked a little bit about it in the past. Again, if you are casually watching these videos, if this is the first video you've seen, in order to fully understand, you need to watch the whole series. So we've done at least two playlists that you need to see in order to fully understand what the Holy Spirit is teaching us here. The first one you want to see is Holy Yahushua Signs and Symbols. The second one you want to see is How to Get on the Ark. And then you should be able to understand this better. If you are a baby in Christ, then I suggest going all the way back to the first playlist, which is the 1111 Melchizedek Priesthood. But for those of you who are up to date, you should remember that we've talked about sacred geometry. So here we go again. It's coming back around. So this one, the tetrahedron, it represents fire. Now I went ahead and put those here. I put them in their perspective column row, depending on the order of this chart here. So just respecting the order of the chart, this first row that we're on is fire. The second row is air. The third row is earth. The fourth row right here is water. And the fifth row, the last row, is ether. And that, again, saints, it fits perfectly if you remember that this fifth row is talking about when we come into our full maturity as the Melchizedek priesthood, the 1111, the mature spiritual sons of Holy Yahushua. It is talking about the escape. It is talking about when we make it to the holy bridal chamber and the wedding feast of the Lamb. That's when we're getting to this fifth row. So it would make total and complete sense that it would be the ether, because from what we're understanding, we're going to be traveling through a portal. And of course, this has to do with the ether. So I don't have the answers right now, but I just want you to know that the Holy Spirit is teaching us this message, and we will understand it as we go along. So if you, in your life, you're having these dreams or visions, or you're seeing these colors or the numbers or whatever, you can, maybe it can help you in the short term to understand that this is the message that we're collectively receiving. But we will talk about the ether in another video. So I have added that to our chart. So as far as I know, it seems to me that this chart is complete. Yes, there might, Holy Spirit might bring some other point that we need to add, but in my feeling, in my spirit, I feel like this chart for the moment is complete. In the next couple of videos, we need to deal with the twins, and we need to deal with the Hunger Games. And before we finish with this row, we also have to deal with 101, which is the portal, because that goes with this space stone right here. After that, I imagine in one or two videos, we'll be ready to go on to this next row right here. And this next row is really important because it has to do with us being born, okay? So the twins' message is kind of like a transition into the next row, which has to do with the mother, it has to do with the woman of Revelation 12, and it has to do with us being born as the two witnesses, the two candlesticks, the twins. So as far as the Bible countdown, if you remember, saints, we are in this area. If I pull out the Bible countdown, you'll remember that this is exactly where we are, Revelation 12, 5, 6, and 7. And this is where the male child is born. Now, we said before, the male child, it's representing spiritually mature sons of Holy Yahushua, but that is not about a human sex situation. It's not for men, masculine men with Y chromosomes. This is a symbolic term for mature, spiritually mature people, not the male sex. And this is talking about the body of Christ being born, the true church, the true body of Christ. Now, if you look here, I think it's funny that it's talking about ruling with a rod of iron, because we talked about that. If you remember, we talked about that with the rainbow, and we were talking about the supernova and the gamma. And we saw right here that the iron is purple, and purple is also the highest frequency as far as light and sound. And it is the iron, purple, right here. That is the element represented by purple. So here, when it's saying that we rule with a rod of iron, it is symbolically talking about us, again, being spiritually mature. And when we're talking about our crown chakra, again, if you're someone who's going to flip out and run away screaming because I said the word chakra, please go to the Most High Father and ask Him to teach you these things, and go back and watch the past videos where I meticulously explained how these are messages from the Most High Father, and I've shown and given proof. We are not talking about New Age here, okay? But do not reject knowledge, especially out of fear. Fear is not of the Most High Father, okay? I don't have time in every video to go back and explain every little point, so please do your own work and do your own research and take it to the Most High Father yourself. But as we've said in the past videos, your crown chakra here is purple, okay, saints? So again, that is symbolism in the Bible when they're talking about you'll receive your crown and all of that. We're talking about the purple, so we're talking about once more being spiritually mature, okay? And as we now know from the rainbow, that is represented by iron. And her child was caught up unto God and to His throne. So saints, this is exactly what we've been talking about over the past few videos, that Holy Yahushua is calling us to go up to heaven right now to spend time with Him. It's been confirmed. I've shown two or three other messengers and prophets who have confirm this message. They've received this message themselves, and I've shared it with you in the past few videos. And by two or three witnesses, let every matter be established. So this is a message that we're currently receiving, and I've received even more confirmation about that. We are at this time to be going up to heaven and spending time with Holy Yahushua. He is calling us up to the mountain. It is time to go to the mountain. And if you're not able to do this, this is the time that you have to figure that out, and you have to put time aside in your day to be spending with Holy Yahushua. So I'm just going through this to let you know, saints, that this is spiritually what is starting to manifest on earth. So if this part is starting to manifest, then we're actually more... spiritually, what is beginning to happen is this right here, since, and this is exactly what we said at the beginning of the year. This is what's about to spiritually be produced, which we're living through, and this is something that was already starting to be produced spiritually, but now we're starting to see it manifest in events and things around us. And that's what I'm going to be showing you in this video, that these things, Revelation 12, 4, and 5, are starting to be manifested on earth. Okay, saints? Before we get into the Hunger Games, we're going to finish with this row as far as the Hunger Games is concerned, and then we're going to go on to the twins. I just want to remind you from the Bible countdown here, 2016 to 2019, these are when things are spiritually starting to happen, and we don't know how it's going to be manifested and all of that, but this is when we can start to feel these prophecies being significant in our lives. And so right now we're in 2019, and right here I have written, Holy Spirit has had me write, Revelation 12, 5, she brought forth a man-child who was to rule all the nations with a rod of iron, and her child was called up to God and to His throne. So again, when we did this work, we didn't understand what it meant until it happened. Now that it's starting to manifest a little bit in the spiritual world, now we can understand the symbolism. Now we can understand the rod of iron representing purple and spiritual maturity. Now we can understand the child is actually representing the church. We had an idea before, but now we're living through it and we know it, okay? And we know about the message that we're being called up to the mountain. This is facts. These are facts, okay? Now we can understand that this is correct. Revelation 12, 5, this is the time frame that we're looking at for this to happen. And if this is true, that means this is equally true. Revelation 11, 3, saints, one more time, that is why you are seeing 11, 3, and 3, 11, and 9, 11. Saints, if you go back to my YouTube channel and you look at some of the first videos I did, I explained that I was seeing 11-3, 3-11, 9-11, 11-13, 11-19, that whole thing. It's happening again, okay? And I'm going to be explaining, when I'm talking about the twins, I'll be explaining why I think that is, or my understanding of why that is. But I just want to point out to you again here, we have Revelation 12, 5, Revelation 11, 3 right here for this time period, 2016 to 2019. You guys see, it just doesn't stop right here. 611. So 611 is very significant, but you turn it upside down, you have 911. I mean, it's just everywhere. So we're going to go through the first Hunger Games movie very quickly. I'm not going to do like, you know, I've done in the past. Sometimes I can spend a whole hour just like meticulously going through every detail of a film. I'm not going to do that this time because we're more mature now spiritually, and your eyes are starting to develop. My eyes are developing as well. So I don't need to explain things to you as much in detail as before. We're all growing. We all have these dreams. We all have our direct relationship with Holy Yahushua. If you've been watching these videos, we're all on the same page as far as what we've been seeing and understanding. So this should make sense to you on your own. You don't need me to explain this anymore. I'm just pointing it out for us as the collective, so we're on the same page. Now, this Hunger Games movie, the whole series, it is just showing us in a fictional scenario the prophecies. It's showing us in a fictional scenario what we are living through and what we will be living through very shortly. Okay, as we've said before, we are the main character that you see on the screen. We are her and the guy. Those two people that are on fire, that is representing the two witnesses. This is representing the two candlesticks. This is representing the five groups of the bridal army, true spiritual Israel. That's us, okay? And it's what we're going to have to go through. So let's look at this first part. This first movie is representing the first row. This is what you should be experiencing at this time. So the movie starts with Deep in the Meadow. It's a song that the character sings to calm her little sister. Now, I want to remind you that we spent a lot of time talking about the meadow. It is in a letter line. So if you remember, it's in letter line 66. We went over that and we were talking about this, the meadow of water, the sweetness, remember? And we broke that down and we talked about what the meadow is. If you remember, this is the meadow. And here I even I put her picture here so you could see. And I said, we are burning like in Daniel 3, NICHOMASHA, that's the message I received. And we are given a bow and arrow. We are Yahushua's mockingjays. Now we know more about this bow and arrow. We know it means Israel. And so this was where we received the meadow, the meadow message. So to remind you, you can go back and read letter line 66 on the website anytime you like. Also, while I'm here, I forgot to mention that the automated number that I got when I took this screenshot of this picture here is 7744. If you look up 7744, it means a child of Abraham and sweetness. So here you have 4477, because you have to do it frontwards and backwards. 4477, sweetness, sweet things. 7744. A son of Abraham. So a sweetness, a son of Abraham, a sweetness, right? And when you go to the letter line 66, what do you have right here? You have sweetness right here, 7744, a son of Abraham, sweetness. And when you come right here, 7744, this is sweetness, a son of Abraham's sweetness, the meadow. That's what this is representing, this picture. This is what it's talking about. It's resonating with the 7744, meaning a son of Abraham's sweetness. And that is also what this picture, this part of the movie, is resonating with. It's talking about deep in the meadow. It's talking about a son of Abraham's sweetness. Are you guys with me? Right here in the movie, this is like the very first part of the movie. Under the willow. Now, saints, we know about the trees. Here in the, right here in the five trees, it tells us about the different trees, the ash, the bodhi, the coral, and right here on the third row, 1, 2, 3, you have the weeping willow. this part right here, this row that we haven't talked about yet, it has to do with protection and the shield. So the weeping willow is symbolically talking about being protected and shielded. That's why we have under the willow in the meadow. This is the place of protection for the children of Abraham. A bed of grass, saints, do you remember the Bible verses we talked about and we said that we are the grass? Do you remember that? I'll put it on the screen here. We are the grass. Also, do you remember the Bible verses that said, do not harm the grass until everyone is sealed, right? Again, right here, the reference to grass. A soft green pillow. Also, we have the reference to green. We all know that green is love. We've talked about that with the angel Raphael, green. How many times is your name in today? So this is, they're talking about her name being put in the hat to be selected for the games. 42, when you look it up, I know it has many more meanings than I can explain here, but I'll just show you what I have to offer through the Holy Spirit. So this is 42, and again, saints, it's not finished. This is just like a first draft. But as I said before, you don't technically need me to be able to understand this for yourself. And if you can't do it now, you will be able to do it more and more. So a holy or sanctified state, sacredness, properly the quality. So this is the Greek meaning of 42 in Strong's. My father is delight, the father of Barak, father of pleasantness, graciousness. This is the Hebrew meaning in Strong's. Orangeness, this is the meaning from the thesaurus. Roger's thesaurus number 5. 370 is the second holy letter, which comes from gematria, the Hebrew gematria of orangeness. If you translate this into Hebrew and do gematria, Hebrew gematria on it, you get 370. And then you get these words here from Roger, abandonment, unworthy, inadequate, unfit, touch, where, whence, where. You are in a state of holiness. You are in a sanctified state. As through grace, you are in pleasantness because Yahuwah is your delight. So I want you to see that that is what you're seeing in this picture right here. She is on the mountaintop. She is in the mountains here. You see the mountains? When I go to spend time with Holy Yahushua in my meditations on him, which, as I've explained before, become more than meditations. They change your life. This is very similar to what I see. And so this is representing the meadow. This is representing being on the mountaintop. This is representing the sweetness of the children of Abraham. This is where we need to be right now. And this is where the movie begins. She has, in her state that she's in right now, she has gotten rid of the dung. She is in a holy state, a righteous state, and she is communing in the meadow with Holy Yahushua. That's what this is representing in this picture. You have come from the light, from the place where the light came into being by itself, established itself. Then the ruler of the underworld took you. Thus you were ignorant of the Father and did not see him. So those who have seen the movie, you know that she's about to go through a lot of tribulation. Orange is like the color of the captives or prisoners. Like orange is the new black. We got that from here, orangeness. Like orange is the new black on Netflix or Isaiah 61:1. You abandon the idea of feeling inadequate or unworthy. So here, when we're talking about captives, we're talking about, you know, in the movie, you see you have the people here and they're like slaves. They're captives. Our understanding of captives are people who are in the matrix and they're asleep in the matrix. They don't really understand what's really going on. Those are captives. When you get touched by holy fire, you gain strength and learn about the expressions of the Father. Now, the holy fire, we're going to see her get touched by the holy fire later in the movie. And you know, you are known, you are glorified, and you give glory to the Most High Father wherever you are. So again, this isn't really written well, but it gives us an idea of what this picture is describing or showing us spiritually. Right now, this is where we are. Right now, those who have gotten rid of the dung and those who have that direct connection with Holy Yahushua, we are in a state of righteousness, a state of holiness, and we are going to be going through tribulation. We're going to be going through an automobile race. We're going to be going through a contest. We're going to be going through the harvest. That's what this is showing. But this is before. Calm before the storm. For the honor of representing District 12 in the 74th annual Hunger Games. So right here, District 12, you guys know that that's talking about the 12 tribes of Israel. 74, let's look quickly at 74. So properly the feeling of the athlete before the contest. Saints, guys, do you think I can make this up? I can't make this up. It's real. And it's right before your eyes. I'm showing you, Holy Spirit is showing you right before your eyes. If you don't know Holy Yahushua, I pray that you repent of your sins and you come to Him right now. Properly, the feeling of the athlete before the contest. Great fear, terror of death, anxiety, agony. This picture right here is exactly that. She's standing there waiting to find out who is going to be called to be in the Hunger Games. Guys. Right here, 74 annual Hunger Games. That's exactly what the picture is showing. My Father is lamp, my Father is light. We know this from the last letter line. That's what it was saying. Sensations of touch, disrespect, there to yonder place, evening, night, curse, selfishness to wrap up, fold together. You are soon to begin or have begun the spiritual race, a contest as in Hebrews 12:1 and the 1 Corinthians. So saints, they call it the spiritual race or the race, but it is also called, it's called the marathon, but it's also called the automobile race. And I'm going to be explaining that later. And you have great fear and anxiety about it. Saints, this is where we are right now in this. This is where we are right now. It is agony. As in terror and death, you are being enlightened as you are in movement upward with design to reach the aeons in heaven. Again, right here, it says that we're supposed to be going to heaven. Exactly. For he, Yah, is good and his children are perfect and worthy of his name. Yahushua says, often you have desired to hear these things of mine and you have no one else from whom to hear them. Give ear, O Israel, Israel, thou that leadeth Joseph like a flock, thou that dwelleth between the cherubims, shine forth. Again, right here, it is telling us it's time to be listening to knowledge, what Holy Yahushua is telling us, what Ruach HaKodesh is telling us, and stand up and to be leaders and to shine forth. This is what it is. I had a dream last night. It was an experience like what I went through at the beginning of this journey when I was being downloaded for the first time, and I've already explained that in past videos. Well, it happened again the other night, and it was so intense. It just felt like the energy was going through me. I was sleeping, and it was just like, woo, woo, woo. The energy was going through me, and it just feels it feels uncomfortable. It feels like if you're on an amusement ride, and you know, something that makes you drop really quickly in your stomach, you know, that feeling in your stomach when you're dropping like that, and it's just like, oh, this uncomfortable feeling. But it's like that throughout my whole body. It's just, whoo, this energy was going through me. And it was to the point where I couldn't lay on my side because it was like the energy wasn't able to go through fast enough. I had to, in my bed, I had to put my leg, I'll show you a picture. I had to put my leg like this. I had to lay as straight as possible and put myself like this. You know, I had to put myself as straight as possible so that the energy could just go through me because it was so intense. And I received a holy letter in my sleep while I was going through this process, and it was 450. So when you look up 450 on Strong's, it says it means God knows. Okay, God knows, that's Hebrew. God knows. And then you look up in Greek and it says, to raise up, to rise. I rise from among the dead. That's what I told you guys in a few videos back. Sister Polly and I had received the messages that the dead in Christ are rising, right? And so here you go again, more confirmation. To rise, I appear. And we are all dead in Christ. And you have to die in Christ in order to be resurrected. To cause, to bring forward, to rise up, cause to be born. rise up, jump up, stand up. So saints, I just received this message the night before last night, as Sister Polly and Brother David are my witnesses. I shared that with them. And here you go in the letter line right here. You are being enlightened as you are in movement upward with the design to reach the aeons. For he, Yah, is good, and his children are perfect and worthy of his name. Shepherd of Israel, thou that leadeth Joseph like a flock, that thou dwelleth between the cherubims, shine forth. It means to stand up, to show yourself, to appear. You shine forth, you appear. That's what this is talking about right here. If you humble yourself, you will greatly be exalted. And if you exalt yourself, you exceedingly be humbled where you are, there where you are. And this is what we've talked about, that we are servants. Then thou fasted that day and put on sackcloth and cast ashes upon your head and rent their clothes. So again, saints, right here, the sackcloth. We talked about that last week. That is an important part of the 311. So pretty much in this letter line, it's just saying everything that we've talked about over the past a couple of weeks, and or even the past couple of playlists, and it's just like putting them all together in a couple of sentences and Bible verses. It's right here for those with eyes to see and ears to hear. You have to fast. You have to put on your sackcloth, okay? My child, do not and rent their clothes. Again, clothes, we're talking about horol shem, about your garments. My child, do not let your mind stare downward at the curse, but rather let it look with the light at things above. The following is the meaning of selfishness. Yahushua says, the Pharisees and the scholars have taken the keys of knowledge. They themselves have hidden them. Neither have they entered, nor have they allowed those who are in the process of entering to enter. As for you, be as shrewd as snakes and as innocent as doves. You wrap up this kind of selfishness and reduce it in an organized manner, making it easier to deal with. My mouth shall speak of wisdom, and the meditation of my heart shall be of understanding. Saints, this right here, remember that in this first row of the five trees messages, we have this message right here about wisdom. Do you remember? And this is about us being pillars to the tabernacle. Do you remember? As the Melchizedek priesthood, right here, the wisdom message. And again, we have it right here about wisdom and the fruits of the Holy Spirit. And this is what the priesthood are. These are the qualities of the priesthood. This is what we're doing. This is how and why and when we're doing it. And all of that is right here in this picture with the 74 and the 12 tribes of Israel as she is waiting to be chosen for the Hunger Games. The feeling of an athlete before the contest, fear, terror of death. Right here. Let's have a big hand for our first volunteer, Katniss Everdeen. Again, I hope you saw the movie, because this is just a reminder. I can't go through and explain it. I'm just pointing out points. The fact that she was a volunteer is everything. Right now, where we are in our spiritual development, it's like Holy Father has done everything. He's loved us first. He's raised us. He's known us. He's raised us. He's made us who we are. He's put us where we are. And now we are appearing. We are rising up. We are being born. Okay. We are being resurrected. We are here. Okay. This is happening now. But in order for you to get from everything Father has done for you, all of the talents that he has given you, as we saw in the message last week, the talents that he's given you, in order to go from this unrealized state to a realized state, it is you who has to voluntarily, you have to volunteer and say yes. And that is what we did on September 11th, which was the first part, which was confessing with your lips. So Holy Yahushua knows, okay, she has received the message, she has accepted. So that part was done. And now you need to physically, as we've been saying over the past couple of weeks, you need to be physically moving right now in whatever way the Holy Spirit is moving you to do so, whether it is the smallest thing of just standing out on faith, in whatever way Holy Spirit is telling you to do. Whatever it is, on whatever level, you have to be right now doing. And don't do unless Holy Spirit tells you to do. You be obedient. Don't make up stuff in your mind. You find Holy Yahushua, you commune with him, you ask him what he would have of you, and then you do that. Okay? Just a quick message about righteousness. Be very careful, saints, to not fall into the trap of your own mental brain and your own mental thinking. That is not where righteousness is. What it is that we're incapable of being righteous, okay? It's not possible, so don't try. Don't try. It's impossible. What you do is you go to Holy Yahushua, you find him. I've explained in the other videos how to do this, okay? So go back and watch those videos if you don't know what I'm talking about. You find him, you commune with him, and he will start to change you from the inside out. He will take out those things that will stop you from being with him. He will change you. You will die, your old self will die in Christ, and you will be resurrected as a new person. And I know this from personal experience. I stopped smoking, I stopped drinking, I'm a brand new person, and not because of my will and my ability. I can't talk about that now in this video. I will come back and talk about it in another video, but the point that I want you to understand here is that this character was already on the mountain with Holy Yahushua. And because she was on the mountain, this is why she is able to do this next step. And this is why she is going to be able to do it, because Holy Yahushua, not because of her, because of Holy Yahushua. The one thing that she did was that she stood up on faith, through faith, to take that step and volunteer. That's all she had to do. That's all she had to do. That's it. And the rest is history. Okay, so it is the same for you and me, brothers and sisters. Be obedient. Be faithful. Whatever Holy Yahushua is calling you to do, you do it, and you don't worry about anything else. It will be written in your mind. His laws will be written in your mind and on your heart, and you will just do what it is, because you know what it is, because you love him and you are obedient to him. That is righteousness, nothing else. So here we can see, this is when they get the holy fire. Holy fire will burn through the church. This is where they get it. And again, saints, just to remind you, on this first row, we're talking about fire. This is the holy fire message that I've received from the beginning of this ministry, fire. They receive this after they have volunteered and they've stood up and here they are being presented, as it says in the letter line, as it says here in the letter line, to shine forth, and you will be exalted if you're humble and all of this. Well, you know she's wearing her sackcloth because she's very sad about her sister. That's why she's doing this, because she's lamenting. So, and all of that leads to her shining forth with the holy fire. Here, saints, we have a picture of them coming together, and that's what we have to do, and that's what we've been talking about for quite a while. We have to come together to do this work, and that has started. So this right here, those who are burning. Do you guys remember that message? NICHOMASHA? Remember, I got that message on my birthday? NICHOMASHA? Well, this is NICHOMASHA. So the people who are burning, we're coming together now. This is representing the twins, the two candlesticks. I had another dream recently. I didn't write it down because I didn't realize how important it was. And then Holy Spirit kept bringing it to me. And that's when I realized it was important. And I shared it with Brother David and Sister Polly as my witnesses. You know, I used to have dreams about the haunted house. I got out of the haunted house. Holy Yahushua saved me. This dream, I was back in the haunted house, but the house was haunted. I was not haunted. Okay, the house was haunted. And at the end of the dream, I mean, I knew the house was haunted. I was like, oh, this house is haunted. I don't want to be in this house, right? So the door was open, and I was really concerned about keeping that door open because I was like, I don't want to get stuck in this house, so like, keep the door open. And the next thing I know, there's a group of people. Now, I don't know if these people were in the house and they got out the house, or if they were not never in the house. I don't know. But it was like maybe, it was a few hundred people, maybe 1,000 people. I mean, it was a large group of people, right? Could have been as large as 1,000 people. And they were outside, and I was saying to them, hey guys, you have to get your candles, because I turned and inside the haunted house was tables. It was kind of like a banquet or something. And there were all these tables and there were candles on all the tables. And I was telling the people, you can't leave without your candles because first of all, it's a fire hazard. You know, the house can burn down or something. That's what I was thinking in the dream. I was like, it's a fire hazard. Don't leave lit candles in the house. But I was like, hey guys, go and get your candles and bring them out of the house, right? And that was the dream. I was telling everybody to go in, get their candles. And I was holding the door while everybody was getting their candles from out of the haunted house. So Holy Spirit was explaining to me, you know, again, this is another confirmation of the candlesticks Bible verse. So again, as we've said in the past, this is representing the fact that we appear, that we show up, and the, you know, who the God of this earth is. He is very aware of who we are. Okay, we know who he is, we know our enemy, and they know who we are. And this right here is the Revelation 11:4, and this is what's spiritually beginning to start right here. It's not yet manifested, but it's spiritually starting to happen. And if any man will hurt them, fire proceedeth out of their mouth, right? So this, saints, is why we have the fire on this first part. These are the twins that are being born. We have the holy fire. We are burning. We're coming together right here in this picture. And your sacrifice. This is amazing because do you remember from the video? And he says,
because you have to be a priest before you can offer a sacrifice, don't you? Because you have to be a priest before you can offer a sacrifice, don't you?
That's what a priest does, the sacrifices. And so right here, this character is saying that the character, the girl, I can't think of her name, Kaddish, she's a priest. And this is how we know. He's talking about her sacrifice. You have to be a priest in order to do a sacrifice. Knife. I put my knife. Saints. I was just stopping the pictures to show you all these words and images that we've dealt with in our dreams and the holy letters and in the visions. All of it is here, saints, for you to understand. Do you remember the knife? The knife, we talked about the knife and the sword.
And the next thing I know, I had a knife and I was threatening him, go away. And he would not move. And so I just started cutting him and it didn't faze him. And then I just like stabbed him and it didn't faze him. It did nothing to him. So the more that it did not faze him, the more I was cutting him. And guys, I butchered this man. I mean, I cut his neck. It was gory and bloody and disgusting. And that's how I felt in the dream. I felt bloody and gory and disgusting.
So, saints, do you remember here you see on the screen the Bible countdown where we're talking about our sword? And we went through that whole study and was showing how it's also the knife. We had the Bible verse that was explaining what the knife is. And I had the dream about having the knife and I cut up the man. I don't know if you remember this, but it was a dream I had, and the guy came to the door and I cut him up into pieces with the knife. Well, here you go again, talking about the knife. Here, right here, it says, see, we are the trees. Can that get any more specific? I understand who people who are blind spiritually and deaf, I can see that they don't know. But you who are a child of the Most High Father, who have these dreams, who hear these voices, who read the Bible, who know the prophecies and who have been following along, this should be as clear as day to you. We are the trees right here. And he says, see, 11. Again, did we not just talk about 11 last week? How often have we talked about 11? 11 is the catalyst. Last week, we just talked about 8:11. Right here, Last week, we talked about 8-11, and we said that 8-11 is the catalyst of completion and new beginning. That is exactly what's happening right now, saints. We are going through a catalyst. Something is happening and will happen. It's happening now in the spiritual world, but it's going to be happening. It's going to be manifesting, and this is going to catapult us into a new beginning, a completion of our spiritual development up until this point, and then catapulting us into the new point. So this is the salt. The 11. This is the gasoline. This is the thing that's going to cause us to go. Now, this is a point I wanted to explain before. There are three waves, okay? From my understanding, I could be wrong, but my understanding is I personally am a second waver. There is a first wave of people, and half of those people will be going in the event. They're going to be going home because they've done their work. We've talked about this in the past. I've proven it to the best of my ability and shown that. The other half of this first wave is going to come and join us. Now, these people are saved. These people are mature, spiritually mature sons of Yah. It's just that they're not fully activated yet. They're not fully understanding the matrix. They're not fully, like, they're not 100% doing this work with us right now. But when this event manifests, they will come and join us. Okay, so that 11 is spiritually happening now, and it will be manifested later for all of us on different levels. Girl on fire. Do I need to say anything else? But these people, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the main characters here. And there are five of them in this picture. And of course, we're talking about NICHOMASHA being on fire. Okay, so here we can see the dress is on fire. Again, this has to do with the messages I've received about Horal Shem, that is the garment, and holy fire burning through the church. We also have the fact that the dress is red. We're talking about the blood of Christ, yes? They don't own me. You know if I'm going to die, I want to still be me. So right here, this spiritually speaking, he's talking about what we've been talking about, the choice of just plain dying or dying in Christ and being resurrected. It's that choice of when you're awake and you really understand what the matrix is, you really understand what the fight is, and you really understand that you don't really have a choice. You don't really. The end of this road is death. If you want to live, you have to die in Christ. You really, honestly, if you really understand this game, that's your only choice. That is your only hope, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Okay? So that's what he's talking about right here. Making that choice. So this, this is now she's in the wilderness. And again, spiritually speaking, this is starting to happen. But we all are very aware that spiritually, this is starting to happen. We are either getting ready to go to the wilderness, or we're already in the wilderness. But it is spiritually speaking, these things are starting to happen. And I'm not quite sure if it's actually manifested yet. It's really hard to know because I don't know what to expect. But in this movie, we can see that she is in the wilderness. So this first row that we're dealing with, we know that we're going to be going into the wilderness in this first row. And of course, we have the enemy who's after us. This is important because there was a video I can't remember her name right now, but this sister on the screen, she put out, and it's called The New Level Devil. If you haven't seen it, I suggest you watch it because it was very helpful for me. It really helps me a lot. So maybe it will be helpful for you as well. So there's a new level devil that's on the lurk. Okay, so if we hear that means we're okay and we'll be back real soon. Okay, so this scene right here is when she's in the wilderness and there's a little girl she's taking care of. And this is why they call her the Mockingjay, because the Mockingjays, they repeat whatever sound. And so if you, there's some kind of whistle that she does, and then the Mockingjays copy her whistle. And then, so she's telling the little girl that is the way they will signal each other. If you hear that sound, then you know I'm on my way. It means that I'm okay and I'll be back real soon. So saints, this is what I understood watching this movie. That's why we are the Mockingjays. I'll say it again, saints. We are the mockingjays. Why? We are Holy Yahushua's mockingjays. Do you understand what I'm saying? Do you understand what the Holy Spirit is saying, saints? So we are the ones Holy Yahushua is saying, okay? And we are the ones that are repeating the message to our brothers and sisters. And the message is that we're okay, and Holy Yahushua will be back real soon. Do you see? That's why we are the mockingjays. We are the ones that are repeating the messages that Holy Yahushua is giving us. And when you hear this message, when you hear the mockingjay, when you hear us, the message is that we're okay. And Holy Yahushua is going to come back real soon, okay? And so that is why she is called the mockingjay, and that is why it is representative. We are, it is representing us as our jobs as messengers and priests. You're fine, see? So this is showing some of the work that we're going to be doing in the harvest. And many of us are already doing this work. So at the same time that we're in the wilderness, it's 3.5 years now. The Prince of Persia is supposed to appear in 2022, around the 22 area, okay? And like I said before, you know if this is true, because if what we talked about in the Bible countdown in the past, if what we talked about in the past comes true and it is scriptural, then we can say that there's a good possibility that what is written for the future will also manifest. Now, what is written for the manifestation of the Prince of Persia to drop his mask falls around the 2022 year point. Now, we don't know if that's a spiritual manifestation or a physical actual manifestation. We don't know. But that's prophetically, that's what I've understand the time period that we're to look for those prophecies to be coming true. So, all of that to say that 2022 right now is 2019. So it's very possible that the physical entering of the wilderness has not exactly happened yet. It's spiritually starting to happen, but it hasn't really manifested yet. But we can look for that to start to manifest very soon, very shortly, right? And so in this movie, she is in the wilderness, and as she is in the wilderness, all heck is breaking loose in the world. So there's literal revolution. And that's why I say that perhaps we're not actually physically in the wilderness yet. Maybe we're spiritually in the wilderness, but we're not physically in the wilderness, because the revolutions are starting, but they're not really, really hot yet. And in this movie, they were hot. They were full on in revolution when she's in the wilderness. So that we can see that here in the movie. They've already found me. Who knows, the pie song in your head, shut straight up. So this is funny because it says the pie song.
100 digits of pi.
3.14159, this is pi, followed by 2653589, circumference over diameter 79, then 323, OMG, can't you see? 8462643, and now we're on a spree.
Pie song, anyone? Pie. I don't have to explain to you guys about pie, right? We're past that point. Right here, pie. And so this is the end of the forest where they have to defeat the enemy. Now, I didn't take a picture of it, but in this movie, they jump up on top of this thing, and there's these wolves or these dogs that are jumping and trying to get at them. That reminded me of a dream that I had years ago, and I've talked about it before in past videos. I jumped up on the wall, and again, this reminds me of Sister Polly's dream where she said I jumped up on the wall. We talked about this in a few videos ago. So in this old video, I also jumped up on the wall and there were these wolves that were like jumping and trying to get me, but they couldn't get me because I was on top of this wall. And so this scene, this ending scene here, when they win the Hunger Games, it reminded me of that dream. And I think that it represents us being on the wall, me being on the wall in the dream and having the dogs or the wolves coming after us and this kind of similar scene in this movie. I think it represents an event, you know, like it could be a terror event. It could be, I don't know what event it is, but it just seems like it represents some event that's going to happen that we're going to be protected from because we're going to be on the wall. And I've shown you guys in the past video what that represents, being on the wall. So, and that's also why I say, we have to be ready. You have to go through everything. When you're watching this movie, everything that happens to this woman before this scene is what you have to be going through, in order to be on that wall when the event happens. Do you see what I mean? You can't wait until the event happens and then try to get on the wall. You can't do it. It's not going to work. You have to be doing this work now. That's what I'm explaining, before the event happens. And we can see that clear in this movie. That's how she wins the first Hunger Games. Okay. And I don't know about you guys, but I feel this when I'm living my life. It feels like I'm in an automobile race. It feels like I'm in a marathon. It is a daily grind. It is a daily, every time I open my eyes, boop, 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 boop. I got to do this until I close my eyes. There is very, very little space in my day for rest and relaxation. Very little bit, you know, just what I need to be well physically. That's it. So, I pray that you guys are also running this marathon and in this automobile race, because that is how you know that you're in the five groups. If you are not living that way, if you are not daily doing this work, you need to get to it before the event happens. Please, again, take all of these things to the Most High Father and get your own confirmations. And again, please know that it's not me saying these things. I'm just showing you what I'm being shown and given. All glory, honor, all praise, glory, and honor to the Most High Father. Thank you, Ruach HaKodesh, for guiding me once more to share these messages with my brethren. I love you all so very much in Christ. All glory to the Most High Father. Holy is Yahushua. Enjoy your Sabbath, saints. Shalom.